LS engines come in a lot of different flavors. Today we're going to talk about some of the differences you may find in 24x 1x applications. In 2005 to 2006, GM mixed it up a little bit with the LS2. They took a 24x 1x engine that conventionally had the cam sensor located at the back of the engine, and they moved it to the front of the engine in the timing cover like a 58x engine, some of the later model LS2 as well as LS3 in later applications. The problem you will find with this is that if you have a 2005 to 2006 LS2, it may have been a takeout engine from a Trailblazer, GTO, or some Corvettes, or some of the early LSX applications with the cam sensor mounted in the front with a 1X cam and a 24X crank sensor, is a conventional 24X harness isn't really going to work out for you because the cam connector and the harness is short and it's not going to be long enough to reach to the front. I've seen people take these harnesses, cut them apart, extend out about 24 inches on the cam sensor wiring to reach the front of the engine, try to keep the shielding intact. Then they also find out that the knock sensors on those engines aren't in the lifter valley like early 24X 1X engines, they're down in the sides of the block. So what you could possibly do is take a 58X harness, which will dress out properly on the engine. But there's another difference. Just because the sensors between a 24X and a 58X engine may look the same other than the color, there's another difference between them, and that is their actual operating voltages. 24X 1X sensors are engineered and designed to work with 12 volts. They have a battery ground and battery 12 volt power feed. 58X 4X sensors are designed to work on a sensor 5 volt reference and a specific sensor ground. So they're not really going to be directly interchangeable. I've seen some folks take a 58X harness and cut it apart and take the 5 volt reference and the sensor ground and wire and splice those into battery ground and battery voltage. But I'm going to tell you that you really don't need to do that. If you have a Holley system, whether you have a Dominator, an HP, a Terminator LS, or one of the new Terminator X or Terminator X Max systems, and you have one of the odd 24X 1X applications with the cam sensor in the front, or you may have an engine that's got an odd mix, you might have a 24X crank with a 4X sensor in the front, or vice versa. One of the things that can help you out is make a simple modification to this harness. You don't need to cut it apart like a lot of people do and try to change the voltages on it to 12 volts. What I happen to know is that if you have one of the Holley systems, if you supply it with a 5 volt square wave reference that you would generate with this harness, it will function fine because the internal switching threshold is 3.5 volts. So as long as your signal going into the ECU on the cam or the crank exceeds 3.5 volts, it's going to function fine. The problem, however, is that these sensors are not wired the same. You're going to need to make a simple modification by just swapping pin A and C, switching those two wires around. You don't need a lot of fancy special tools, but I would recommend getting a proper Metropack 150 depinning tool. You can get a Holley part number 567-101 or an equivalent. You'll need a small screwdriver, possibly a pocket knife, and a little bit of electrical tape. So if you guys want to zoom in over here, we'll look at this a little bit closer and we'll show you how to do it. The first thing you'll need to do is look at your harness and find the connector that is labeled cam. Now, you could work with this harness and try to modify it without removing the tape, but if you remove the tape, it's going to give you a little extra wiggle room with the wires. So I would normally just take a knife and carefully remove the tape, and you want to be careful that you don't cut into the wires or the loom. The next thing you're going to want to do is remove what they refer to as the TPA, or terminal position assurance, and you can usually pull this loose with your fingers or a small screwdriver. Remove that and set that off to the side because we'll be reinstalling that later. Now you need to get the appropriate tool. So you can get a Holley 567-101 or equivalent, and when you go to remove the pins, when you look at the connector, you'll see up at the top side of it, there's a little depression on A, B, and C. You want to take your pin tool and carefully, this shouldn't require a lot of force, but you'll want to insert it above that pin, and you'll feel it when it engages, and just carefully release the detent. Now, when we look at the connector, it will be labeled A, B, and C. And what you're going to just simply need to do is remove the A pin and the C pin and you're gonna need to switch them. But now since we've depressed the detent lock, you're gonna need to carefully pick that back up. And you just don't need to get carried away with it. You just wanna bring it up just a little bit so that it'll be able to re-engage in the connector. You don't wanna bend it too far, and you definitely don't wanna break it off. If you do accidentally damage the connector or the pins, they are available from Holley or your local Holley dealer, so you would be able to get those and switch them out. You would then just carefully reinsert the connector, line it up, push it in gently till you hear it click, and do the same thing on the second wire. Once you get those installed, you can reinstall the TPA. Be careful, make sure that you get the wires separated. Lock that back in. I would take a little bit of electrical tape. I use good quality harness tape. It's worth a little extra expense to buy quality materials. And you're good to go. Now, depending on the application, you may need to modify the settings in the software, and we'll cover that next. Now that you have your harness modified, you'll need to go in and set up the software. If you're not dealing with a, what I call a Franken motor, where you may have a 24X crank in the engine with a 4X cam or a 58X crank with a 1X cam, you could simply go in and program in the 58X, 4X, or the 24X, 1X settings that are in the immediate drop-down menu. But if you have an engine that's kind of got a mashup of mixed cam and crank sensors, you'll need to go in through the custom ignition settings to set that up. I'm going to go ahead and show you how to do it now. To program the proper ignition type in the software, you go to ignition parameters. The layout of the software between conventional Holley EFI systems and Terminator X is slightly different, but the overall setup will be the same. In the ignition type dropdown, you would want to look for 58X or 24X LS. These options would be used if you have a factory cam and crank sensor combination. If you have a combination that requires custom configurations, for example, 58X, 1X, you would go to custom and then select configure. In this case, we're showing a factory 58X crank with a 4X cam. We may have a 58X crank sensor with a 1X cam, in which case we would select single pulse, and then our sensor type. You want to make sure with a LS1X cam sensor that the sensor type is set for digital rising. It could be that we have a 24X crank with a 4X cam, and you would set it up accordingly. Below that, you'll find the output setup. You would want to make sure that your output type is always going to be set for a DIS coil on plug, and the dwell time will need to be programmed based on the coil manufacturer's specifications. Different coils and different manufacturers are going to have different dwell times, and it's going to be important to make sure that you follow their recommendations. When you're programming the dwell time for factory LS coils, most factory 58X LS coils used a dwell time of 3.5 milliseconds. If you had a factory 24X coil, they would generally have been programmed to 4.5 milliseconds. Now that you have your ignition type set up, you would simply go ahead and send that to the ECU and then cycle the ignition key. Now that you have your global file properly configured for the correct ignition type for your application, you can go ahead and send that file to the ECU. So remember that if you haven't already done it, it's a new installation, and perform a TPS auto set before you try to start the engine. For more helpful Holley tech tips and videos, go to holley.com.